like to introduce the lady in this room who needs absolutely no introduction. Elisabetta, tell us about your year.
There we go with my not a year in your life, but life in a year, because it was literally one of the best experiences that I ever had in my life. So, you know, let's start. I have like a bunch of pictures. There's a lot of pictures. I'll explain something about some of those, some others we're just gonna pass through. This one is the first picture that I took in America. I was at the airport and all my families came and they welcomed me. I was so overwhelmed, kind of crying. It was just awesome. And that's one of my like best memories about this exchange. It was just amazing. This is Julia, Robert, Grace, and Harrison waiting for me. And they told me that Robert was screaming my name at every single person that was coming out of the gate. Betty! You know? Anyways, this is my second night here, still with jet lag and everything. I remember the girl, the blonde girl in the middle, she invited me over at 6 in the afternoon to watch a movie. We watched Pitch Perfect. And I remember Julia telling me, you go ahead, I'm getting out of work at 9, so you go, and then I'll meet you there. And I remember, without knowing any language, or I don't know anyone, I didn't know their name, and I went there, and I felt like awesome, because I started my experience here, like, you know, being here now is one of the slogan of Rotary International. This is when I went swing dancing. So, you know, just with my friends, we went to Minneapolis. That was pretty cool. This is the state fair. As you can tell, there's food on a stick. And I went with Julian Harrison, and it was just nice and really overwhelming. Still, I was here for a week, so, you know, I didn't understand a lot, but it was just really unhealthy food, a really fun trip. This is our first day of school. I was with my first trio of siblings, and that's how we felt. This is Julia and Nathan. They are twins, and they are seniors like me, so that helped a lot too. And Sam, which is a freshman, you know. This is my first football game. There we go. And I remember I was with my friends, and I got to meet my first group of friends. That was pretty cool. And I understood how in America this sports thing like put people together, and I really liked it. And there we go. Those are my friends. It took for me a month to learn their names, but they were already my best friends there, so you know. And I really liked it. And this is the Mall of America. We went to the Mall of America with my first family, and you know, still overwhelming, still not knowing the language, seeing the biggest mall of America or whatever, Northern Hemisphere. That was cool. And this is me cooking for my family. This is the pizza that was pretty much good. I don't know, I'll ask you, was it good? Okay. They're not gonna say no though, but that's fine. This is Duluth, and I've been there with my second host family in the first period of my experience here, and I went with Robert, Julia, and Harrison, and this is the sunset over the awesome lake, and it was one of the best experiences at the beginning, and I really had a wonderful time. We were in a cabin up there, just like chilling with my friends, having a bonfire. It was one of the best experiences ever, getting really Minnesota, you know, right away. And this is the Spirit Week, the first Spirit Week before I'm coming. So this is America Days, the second one it's Hawaii, and I'm pretty much in the middle, as you can see. This is 80s Superheroes Day, and this is a Jefferson School Days. Those are my friends, you know. And this is my proposal for Sadie's, no, wait, homecoming. And this is Colin, and this is his proposal, and this is my yes. And I say it in Italian, you know, because. And this is homecoming, and I'm with Nathan and Stephanie and Dan, my first host parents. This is my group. That was pretty cool. It was one of my was my first dance actually in America, because we don't have dances in Italy. So it's like I had so much fun. I really liked it. This is a bonfire that I had. I remember it was a really bonding moment with my friends, and those are the friends that I met at the bonfire, and you know, the one that you see in the picture before, and they, like, I don't think that I didn't, like, I knew all of their names, but, you know, I was working on it. Anyways, those are some of the shows that I saw at Jefferson High School. Another amazing thing about American high school is that we have stuff to do, and there's, like, shows and band concert and people involved, and those are students, as you can see. Robert, it's in one of those, like, the importance of being earnest, and Julia and Sam both in the bottom one. So, you know, my siblings were there. This is a volleyball game that I saw with my first host family and some friends and Sam, and we went to see the Gophers. And this is me meeting with Nicolette. Nicolette was an exchange student last year in Italy, and she's from St. Paul. And we met each other in Italy, and we had the possibility to meet again here. That was just awesome. Like, all the things that Rotary can do for you, and you have friends all over the world, and I came here and I had already friends. That was cool. And this is one of our first overnight with Rotary. We were in Wisconsin, at the border with Wisconsin. So those are some of my friends, and Elisa is from Italy, and Arizona, everyone knows Arizona. The other one is Simon from Croatia. This is the overnight, and it was a Halloween overnight in November, and I'm the one in the middle, pretty scary. Yeah, I was like a skeleton, so, you know. And those are my friends, my Italian friend, the exchange student from Italy. They're here with me. We are all spread out. A couple of those are in Wisconsin, and Elisa is in Minneapolis. And, you know, those are going to be like friends forever or lifelong, you know, just amazing. And this is Halloween. I carved my first pumpkin here. And I dressed up. I went to trick or treat with my siblings, you know, 17 years old kids doing trick or treat. I was really, really cool. And this is me, one of my best, like, pictures ever. I really love it because I'm a cheerleader, guys. And that's one of the American dreams, you know, like being a cheerleader, wearing the uniform, you know. And this is this is my second family. We were leaving for Las Vegas and Colorado, and that was just really nice. And, you know, at 6 in the morning, you can see our faces kind of tired, but, you know, this is me and Harrison and Robert in Las Vegas. And still, that was an amazing experience. We took a picture, of course, with Las Vegas sign. And then from there, we stayed a night. And then from there, we went to the Hoover Dam. And then the picture there, it's me happy at the Hoover Dam. And then we had a road trip, and we went to Colorado. This is the Grand Canyon. And then we stopped in Colorado with Shelly's family for Thanksgiving. And those are my siblings trying to push me down a hill just for fun. It was just taking a picture, you know? This is one of the shows that I saw in school, and this is Robert. You know, you're sponsoring him next year, though. Yeah. And this is me at the Jingle Ball with Harrison that invited me. That was really nice, and I loved it. It was my first concert, by the way. I got my first concert in America. That was pretty nice. Those are still my friends. And this is Sadie. This time I asked him, and there we go. Being athletes, I don't even know. But yeah, that's Sadie. And this is me, Harrison, and Robert again. He said hello to his families, I think. And we made pavlova, which is meringue. but he's really proud about pavlova, you know. So anyways, and we were just bonding, you know. Then I went to Duluth with my first host family, and we celebrate Christmas there. Unfortunately, it was really sad for me because I lost my grandmother in Italy, so it was just not one of my best periods, but still, like, being with them was really helpful, and it was just awesome being there. I love Duluth. Also, if it was like negative 20 or something like that, that was nice. This is our Christmas, and this is one of my favorite pictures ever, because I mean, their family. Look at me. I was like part of their family, and was so happy to be there, and that was just nice, and feeling part of their family, really cool. And this is me and Tina. Tina is an exchange student from Norway. I bonded with a lot of other exchange students from all over places. And it was New Year's Eve, and we went ice skating. I'm really bad at ice skating, like, no way. And the other one was the first of the year, and at Sanneberg we celebrated Christmas, because we passed the other Christmas in Duluth, so we had another Christmas there. That's what's going on with four teenagers at your house, opening presents, you know. And this is when I first moved to my second family, and those are my siblings and family, and we have like all the same T-shirt as you can see, and you know, family, and still sponsoring him next year. it was an awesome welcome, actually. We had this forced family fun time, we call it like that, and we spent time together. It was really cold outside, if I remember, so we were like all in the house, no one left because it was too cold outside. And this is Harrison when he had his last speech here with the year in review. And it was like, it was a funny picture, but it was like a sad moment because it was leaving, but you know. And this when he left, and all the crew to the airport saying goodbye to him. And look, those are all friends of mine too. Like, I know all of them, and I would like to say they are awesome people. And just to see how amazing is being part of like this program. Harrison had all those people at the airport for him, saying goodbye, crying, and I think it's gonna be pretty much the same for me too. And I'm really happy to be here with my families and all that kind of stuff, you know? It's just really cool. I love being, oh, that's me again. Go Jags, go Jags. And actually, this one is my first hockey game, in like the first one in my life, because we don't have hockey in Italy, and we won. And there's Jefferson, go Jags, I'm a cheerleader. this is one of the first snow, I think. This one, the first picture was taken by Gabby, I remember. She was like, send it to your mom. and it was, how do you say? Shoveling. And the second one was at a cabin. Iris was one of the people living with us at Petrie's cabin. And this is me happy in the snow. Happy, I don't know. It was like a moment, just a moment, you know. This is the Super Bowl. There's a picture that I took of the television because I didn't go there, but I actually saw it. You know, that was that was really nice, such a big deal. I watched all the commercials for like 4 hours. That was pretty cool. I love those American things. And this is those are some of the experiences that I got into my school. The first one is a future leader congress that we had here with some, like, with my marketing class, and I've been here in this hotel with some of my friends. And the other one, it's kind of a spirit week before Sadie's, I don't remember. Anyways, there's pajama day. As you can see, the first one, I'm wearing my pajama at school. I told my mom, she didn't believe it though. And she was like, actually in America they do that? Apparently. And then the second one, it's me. No, the third one, it's me and Julia for our decision day, kind of. So she's going to Kansas next year. And I'm going to Italy. I'm not going to Rome, but I'm going to Italy. That's fine. And then still, this when I met the outbound to Italy. So this is Luke and Delaney and Lily and I don't see and Sienna. And anyways, they're coming to my country next year. And I got I got to meet them first, which is, I think, awesome. And so they already have friends there. I know pretty much where every one of those kids. Is going. And this is Tina, one of my best friends, and I wanted to show to you my blazer, which is like getting really full of pins, which like I'm really proud of. And this is me and Tina escorting Robert for the men pageant. And the second picture, I think it's the crashed ice, and I went with some friends. A couple of those are exchange students, some others Robert, and one is Julia's friend Rose. This is my first wild game, the only one actually. I went with Tina and it was amazing, and I really love hockey, so I was like, it was really nice, and we were like in the front row, so it was super, super exciting and awesome. And this is me cooking pasta for my second family. We were at Grace's apartment, and they told me that it was good. I don't really know, but they told me that it was good. So, you know, I'm happy to share with you. I'm really good at cooking. And this is Marcus and Nick. They got married here, and it was just awesome. I just wanted to share it with you, and I got to experience a lot of stuff, and I was there. Well, they were marrying. That's nice. And this is me with Lauren, and we won the most spirited cheerleaders award. So, you know, go Jags. And the second one is just a funny picture of April's Fool to Robert. It was a car full of balloons, you know, it's like a lot of commitment for this. April Fool's in America, it's kind of serious. It's kind of a big deal, you know. And this is this is my second host family. We were celebrating at the St. Paul Hotel with my second family, and was 50th. Shelly 50th birthday and Virgil and Shelly 25th anniversary. That was so nice, and that's just super cool. I lived a lot of amazing experience here. I'm like really happy right now. Anyways, passing through those picture yesterday night made me feel so happy, because I actually put together like what I did in a year, and I would like to say that it's such an awesome year. Like all the pictures all together, because you know I'm living day by day, so. You don't really realize it until you see 80 pictures about all the amazing experience that you live, you know. Anyways, this was one of the collages that I made for Siblings Day, and my caption was one of my social media. My caption was like, I'm an only child in Italy, I don't have any siblings, and here I got to have like 10 siblings or more, and it was just awesome, and I experienced so much different like lives and families, which I think it's cool, because I changed three families, and I have all different kind of parents, experience, siblings, and I was just glad. This is the lake. I took a picture, like I moved to my third host family, and this is one of the pictures I took at the lake, and I'm living like super close to Bush Lake, and it's so charming, so I wanted to put it there, just so you know. And this is, that's when I went with Deb to the twin game, and we actually... They won after 21 inning, am I right? So yeah, we left after 10 or something like that, but they won. Yeah, I was not there, but they won. And this is when Iris left. Iris was living at our house at Petrie's, and she is now an au pair in Switzerland. So we were at the airport saying goodbye to her. This is in a Polaroid. And the other one, it's this Cheesian Day at Jefferson, so that's me and Robert that we actually decided to go away. And we're not going to college straight next year, but I'm getting back to Italy, and he's going to Slovakia. This is Mother's Day, and we went to the sculpture garden with my third house family, and those are Zinnia and Ruby, my sister now. They're so sweet, I love them. And this is the first time, I got to see the sculpture garden, and actually there's just a spoon there because they move everything, but you know, it's like I took a picture with it, so it's like I've been there, check. You know, it's like it was too cold this winter to go there. I mean, I lived in Minneapolis, but I didn't go outside that much. This winter was like, okay, they told me that this winter was really mild, is that the word, mild? But still, like super long, I don't really, like fortunately it was mild for me, because like I was so cold, like Minnesota. Anyways, this is prom, and those are my girlfriends, and we were just having a super chill prom, and I'm happy that I got to experience it. We had a potluck, and we did each other hair and makeup and stuff, and we were it was just awesome, and I really like the preparation, like, you know, all the stuff that you do before more than the dance, because you know, the dance, it's overrated. but it was really nice, and it was like my actual group of friends, and I love them, they're really nice, and I was so glad to spend time with them. And this is my third family taking a picture with me. You know, those two girls came like to our prom preparation, you know, like seeing high school kids with a dress, like dress on and high heel shoes and with like cute makeup. It was really exciting. It was actually cold though. Like as you can see, I was without sleeves and they were wearing like jackets. So, you know, May 13 in Minnesota. And this is Luke. He was my date, and next year he's going to Italy, close to where I live, kind of close, you know. He's going to Brescia, which is still in my region. And that's awesome. Like, I got to meet him through Rotary. He's not even going to a Jefferson High School. I just met him because he's going to my country next year. So we got to speak about the experience, what to expect, what to do, and all that kind of stuff, the culture. Okay, this is Julia. Last concert was yesterday and I miss it. I'm so sorry. But yeah, I've been to 4 of her concerts with the Angelica Cantanti and they're awesome. Just go and see them next year because now they're done, but whatever. And it was just amazing. I got to have musician siblings and they all play an instrument, they sing, they're like really good at that. I'm not even able to, but that I was really glad to be a part of it anyways. And the second one of my best picture, I'm really proud of it. I got a letter in academics and those are all my siblings, like all going to Jefferson High School. Nathan, okay, from here, there's Robert, Julia, no, Sam, Julia, Nathan, and me, the short one, you know. And we all got some awards. Julia and Nathan got a couple scholarships too. That was pretty cool. And they were always on stage, which made me feel so proud of my siblings. Robert won an art award, honor, or something like that. And Sam was, she led her too. You led her too? Yeah, because you're pretty good at school too. And me too. I got a small certificate for being an exchange student at Jefferson, and also got a letter in academics, yes. And this is 2 days ago, my birthday, and those are my sister cards for happy birthday, and I got a crown. That was supposed to be a necklace, but it was so much better as a crown, and two homemade bracelets, and they wrote my name on all the cards, and it was just so nice. And I woke up and I saw this thing on the breakfast table, and it was just so neat, and I felt so good. Anyways, and the second picture, it's the dinner that we had at our house. Thank you. For my birthday on Friday, and I had my first and third family together, and my third host family house, and it was really nice. That's what I wanted to. Because I didn't actually had a lot of time to spend with all my families together. Actually, so far, I don't know if we gather all together in a room so far. So, you know, anyways, and so I really wanted to spend some time with them. But afterwards, I went to a sleepover. So I was like, I hung out with my friends too, you know. I did both and I was really happy. And this is yesterday. My eyes are closed, but whatever, was one of the best pictures that I got. We went out for brunch, and this is my last picture. And Shelly has a Polaroid in her hands, and it's one of the pictures that you saw before when we were all with the same t-shirt at the Petrie's house, my second host family. And it's kind of like a transition, I would like to say, from the past to like the future kind of thing. Like, things are changing, soon we're leaving, which is really sad. And, you know, I really like this picture anyways. We went out for brunch yesterday and we did some other fun stuff. And that's pretty much my experience. And I loved it. Thank you to all of you that like helped me having this amazing experience. I would like to say thank you to my families because they're pretty awesome, all of them. And to Rotary, of course, because I got to be in one of the best experiences of my life. And, you know, thank you. Oh, yes, I'm excited about questions. There we go. Does someone, okay, yes.
I have the impression if you were to describe your experience in one word, it might be the word awesome.
Pretty awesome. Actually, Dan would say full of awesomeness. So. so amazing and full of awesomeness. Okay, yes?
Where are you from in Italy, and what are your plans when you go back?
I'm from the northern part, close to Milan, kind of, like 1 hour far away, 1 hour and a half far away. I still have 1 year of high school when I get back. This is my fourth year, but we have 5 years in Italy, so I still have one. And then I'm going to the university in Italy, pretty much sure that I will do that. I don't know. Yes.
What are your parents' names and what do they do?
My mom's name is Venusta. It's an unusual name. She has a farm. She is running her own business, and she just has field, not animals, but you know. And my dad has his own business, and also he works in the commerce, kind of like he sells cars. I don't know, and he has like a real estate kind of thing. And his name is Carlo. Other questions? Yes.
Do you have anything kind of like a fun thing as soon as you get home or early on? Like a family vacation?
Going to school? No. Sad. No, actually, okay, I have a wedding when I get back. Family friends are getting married, and I'm going with my parents. I'm really happy. And then I'll study a lot this summer. And I have my last year of high school, which is going to be really tough because I missed this year pretty much, so I need to catch up everything. And then I think after that, one of my plans is go through Europe and hang out with my international friends, you know, the friends that I got here with Rotary, some people all over Europe. So I think I will do that. Not soon, but I will. Yes. Dan.
How long did it take you to not use Google Translate?
Well, I'm still using it sometimes. Sometimes just I need to Google it. I don't know how to say it. But I think 4 months. Like to speak, maybe a couple months. And then for other stuff, I need to Google other words. Like to express myself more than what other people were saying. And I need to Google it and then learn it. You know? Yeah, it was helpful.
Thank you so much, Elisabetta.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Okay, it was just...
Well, Karen said a lot of what I was going to say, which is we have been so, so blessed to have you with us. You have been absolutely fabulous. And as you can tell, your enthusiasm is just builds and rubs off on all of us. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
And so as a appreciation for your speaking presentation today, a donation to polio will be made to the End Polio Now, which is a signature project of Rotary International. In the early 1980s, there were 400,000 cases of polio in the world each year, and Rotary decided to join with other organizations to lead the eradication of polio. We are so close to eradicating this devastating disease. We've had 14 cases in 2016, which have been isolated to Pakistan and Afghanistan, and that's compared to 23 cases last year. So we're about half of where we were last year. So success over polio will help fuel the energy for what people in the world can do when we work together. And here is a certificate.
Thank you.
In honor
Thank
of
you.
Your speaking today, and here is a Rotary End Polio Now. Thank you Thank so you. Much. Thank you.